Thank you indeed, Tumi. Now, last October, professional makeup artist and social media influencer Lindy Lin married her Prince Charming, João de Sousa. Their fairy tale wedding was the talk of the town, with many well-known South African personalities in attendance. And of course, Afternoon Express has the newlyweds in studio to hear their story. João and Lindy, or should I say Mr. and Mrs. de Sousa, welcome to The Loft.
Thank you so much. We're so happy to be here.
Now look at them all booed up, holding hands, you know, making me hold a candle, but I'm not even fretting about that, because I want to find out about your story. I mean, Lindy, how did you meet your Prince Charming and where did it all start?
Well, João and I knew each other for a couple of years, but about 4 years ago, he did stalk me one night on social media, and his friends came along to a party that I was at, and from there, it was just all God. It was amazing. Date after date, we haven't been inseparable since.
I mean, João, would you agree? Were you stalking Lindy?
To be honest with you, I was. A good friend of mine actually came back to South Africa because he was going to get married in that same year. So we haven't seen each other for about 3 years, and we went on social media and we needed a place to go and have some fun. And it turns out that I ended up on her page and I found out where she was, and I was like, come guys, let's go here. But at the same time, I was unemployed and I didn't have any money to party. But thankfully, my friend came back and he had us covered. So we went to Lindy. We went there, and funny enough, she was in the VIP section.
Okay.
Because we haven't been out for some time, we got normal bands and we went in and we were ready walking up, you know, to enter VIP and chill with them, get attention somehow.
Uh-huh.
Turns out we couldn't get in because we didn't have VIP bands. So they turned us around.
This is where it gets awkward.
Yeah, exactly. So, but luckily they didn't see us. So they turn us around, we go back, we get the VIP bands, get into the whole groove of things, and they are just not interested in us at all. Like literally, I promise you.
It was my birthday.
We paid the bouncers to set the table up right next to her table. The guys that they were with, they were like, what are these guys doing? And as soon as Lindy walked away with one of her friends, I was like, can I buy you a shot?
Aww.
And she was like, no, and the friend was like, buy her a shot. And I was like, wait, I have a problem. And I shouted for my buddy, I was like, do you have 100 grand for me for a shot?
What?
And that's honestly how we met.
Yeah,
first shot.
Yes, mm-hmm. Love at first shot.
Oh, apparently that engagement to that proposal was a little out of the ordinary.
Yeah.
That's all you.
First of all, everything I said I would never do, I did. So 3 months into it, I was like, listen, it's feasible, let's move in.
Mm-hmm.
Thought I would never ever do that, but on that same conversation, she's like, yeah, you can move in, but don't think we're gonna live together forever. You need to put a ring on it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like, okay, cool. Moved in 3 months later, literally in November that year, I was like, okay, cool, let's get engaged.
Just like that. I mean, sometimes they do say, when you know, you know.
Yeah.
Okay, so you already decided this is the woman you want to be with, and Lindy, you said, listen, ain't nobody gonna get the milk if they don't pay for the cow.
Exactly.
So you gotta put a ring on it and make me an honest woman.
Yes.
I love the fact that you guys are traditional to a certain aspect of it. But the proposal, you know, I'm trying to get to this proposal story.
Listen.
Seen the pictures, yeah.
That proposal, oh my word. Lindy leaves me alone with her friends for a day. Don't know why. I'm alone with them. I'm alone with them chilling for the day. I don't know why she left me. She probably went to go do something.
Shopping.
And these people have the most wonderful ideas about an engagement. But the finances don't match the book a house, get a private chef. I mean, life's that good. No. So they're talking to me and they're like, you need to do this. Because I plan to get engaged.
Yeah.
But they're talking to me and they're scaring the out of me. And I'm literally sitting, listening to them, and I know we're meeting Lindy at the waterfront later, and we go, and I literally walk into a jewelry shop, and I honestly I had a card that I had some savings on, but I didn't know what the limit was. Not because there was lots of money, because I never knew what the limit was.
Yeah.
I never spent over 3,000 Rand.
Or something like
no.
that.
No. So I go to the jewelry shop, and I tell this lady, and I'm like, auntie, you know what?
Yeah.
I want that ring. If this card's gonna go for that ring, I promise you, watch me, I'm gonna go get engaged. She's like, you're lying. Like, swipe that card. And I promise you, it goes through. And I'm like, oh my word, guess what, I have to go do it. So she's in the parking lot, walking to the car. And her friends are like, what are you gonna do? I'm like, I'm gonna propose. And they're like, no, you can't. They're trying to stop me. And I'm like, no, leave me. So I call her, and I'm like, you need to come up. And as soon as she comes up the lift, she walks out, and I get her money, and I'm like, will you marry me? In the middle of the waterfront.
In the mall.
In the middle of the mall.
In the middle.
Jay, you're dressed casually.
Outside the lifts.
Like sneakers, hair's not looking wonderful.
No.
I mean, Lindy, how did you feel about this proposal?
I felt a little bit...
I was going to say no. Yeah. She took it like 15 minutes to say yes.
It was 2 minutes.
Oh.
I did get caught off guard. I mean, I just wanted to look a little cute, you know, in case somebody gets a story or something.
In case you trend and become a meme.
You never know, exactly.
I did become a meme. Thanks to this oak, you can't tie your shoes in the waterfront.
You did become a meme.
Yeah.
So let's get into married life. I mean, you two both look happier than ever before the actual wedding day. I mean, you guys had a bit of a star-studded lineup in terms of that red carpet event. Ooh. Your friends came out, the best of the best within the South African entertainment space, where there was influencers, musicians. They all showed their love to you. I know the MC was Dean Woodman, a very good friend of Afternoon Express. And of course, your very close maid of honor was Nadia Jafta. Again, a very close friend of ours.
Yeah.
So how important is having good cohesion, good synergy and chemistry with the bridal party so there's no drama on the day?
It was really just the best day. We were super blessed. The weather was perfect.
Yeah.
And it was a party, you know?
You guys got married during COVID-19 lockdown. You went from 100 guests to 50 guests.
Yeah.
So not only did you have to cut down, you had to adjust your own expectations, but still want to celebrate love and have a good time. How does one do that?
So it was definitely important that we had our closest people there. Unfortunately, we did have to uninvite 50 people. We had to send them a wonderful little letter and a very big sorry. But other than that, it was absolutely amazing. We had very good service providers that help you with everything. I thought to myself, how am I going to pull this together? But you know, there's so many talented people out there in the Western Cape especially. And yeah, it was just, it all came together.
Praise to God.
All praise to God. It was amazing.
Absolutely. Joao, what were your thoughts when you saw Lindy walk down the aisle?
To be honest with you, I was fortunate enough to not be involved with anything of the wedding.
No plan.
Besides...
showing up.
No, showing up and getting the suit. That was my task. And getting the priest, but I kind of messed that up one. I messed that one up at the beginning.
It seems like there's just so many stories when it comes to this couple. My goodness.
So that was my... Mine was just getting the suit and just turning up. But when I came, honestly, I promise you, when I walked in myself, I was like, wow. Thank you for having me here.
My wedding, but thank you.
Did you tear up
when you guys saw each other for the first time on the day?
Listen, I was crying, and then my best friend starts rubbing my back, and he's crying, and he's like, Joe, are you crying? And I'm like, Lamy, no. My lips are doing this.
They're quivering.
And they're all wearing sunglasses for who knows why.
No, but as soon as she came, because we don't want to be... Imagine as a guy, you standing there for two to three minutes and you are just crying and everyone's just watching you.
Yeah.
No, and then when Lindy walked down, I took my glasses away and you could still see.
The tears.
So yes, it was...
Okay, before I let you guys go, the future of this couple, I hate to get into your uterus like this, Lindy, but can we expect a baby?
I mean, definitely God willing. So not right now, my uterus is okay for now, but we would love to start a family and complete our
plan. Well, all the best to both
of
you. Thank you so much for sharing your love and your story, as crazy as it seems, with us and Afternoon Express. And all the best, guys.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Now, newlyweds Joao and Lindy DeSouza are the perfect example of Valentine's Month romance. And we wish them the very best, not only in their marriage, but also in their lives together as they venture on to start a new family.